Hello, I'm Lyn Jarvis, contributing editor for Across the Fence, and today a travel adventure that's a little bit different. I've been to 47 states, but never to Kansas, Nebraska, and Iowa. And when I tell people this, they say something like, "You're not missing much." Well, today my goal is to prove them wrong and complete my quest to visit all 50 states in this great country of ours. We flew into Kansas City, Missouri, rented a car, and drove across the Missouri River into Kansas City, Kansas, to catch up with Gina Bullard, who used to work at Channel 3.
Live look now at I-35 at Shawnee Mission Parkway. You can see it is very slow right here going southbound on I-35. Also pretty slow this morning on the south side of that 435 loop because of construction. Stay connected with us at kctv5.com and with our free mobile app.
We're beginning our adventure in Kansas City, Kansas. As you can see, I'm with Gina Bullard. She works out here at the CBS station KCTV. And Gina, we miss you back in Vermont. So tell us about what your job is like out here.
I'm so glad you guys came to visit me first. It's so good to see you. I really miss Vermont. I have a pair of Midwest boots on now, but I haven't forgotten about my East Coast roots. But now I'm doing traffic in the morning for the early morning show here, and then I host a show called Better Kansas City, which is kind of like the 30. It's a lifestyle show with live interviews, which is a lot of fun. But I definitely miss Vermont and all the great people there.
Thank you, Gina. And on her advice, we were off to Topeka to visit the state capitol and what an impressive structure it is. Completed in 1903, it is 17 feet higher than the U.S. Capitol in Washington, D.C. Stepping inside, you are awed by the grandeur of the place. This is the rotunda with paintings that depict notable events in Kansas history. Here is the chamber for the 40 senators who are elected to four-year terms. The desks, dating back to 1903, are made from native wild cherry wood. The House chambers are home to 125 state representatives elected for two-year terms. It is adorned with marble and gold leaf columns. And crowning this five-story structure is this dome composed of 265 glass panels and a 900-pound chandelier that illuminates murals and statues below.
Kansas anymore.
Kansas and Oz have always gone hand in hand, and in 2004 the Oz Museum in Wamego opened its doors, and it did not disappoint. More than 2,000 items are in the collection, including this rare first edition book, The Wonderful Wizard of Oz, by author L. Frank Baum. Born in upstate New York, Baum was in his 40s when his book was published in 1900, and 9 years later made it into the iconic movie starring Judy Garland. Enjoy along with us. On we went to Abilene to visit the library, museum, and boyhood home of our 34th president and five-star general, Dwight David Eisenhower. Coming from humble beginnings, this is where he lived with his five brothers and parents until he was accepted to West Point at the age of 20. The home remained in the family until his mother's passing in 1946, when it was deemed a National Historic Site. The 22-acre memorial now includes the presidential library and this 11-foot bronze statue that stands in the center of the campus. One could spend hours in the Eisenhower Museum, built from Kansas limestone that covers his extensive military career and rise to the presidency of the United States. Some highlights include his leadership of the greatest amphibious military operation in history and the 1944 Allied invasion of Nazi-controlled Western Europe. His administration initiated the first civil rights legislation in 1957, and also both Hawaii and Alaska became part of the United States. And concluding our visit is the place of meditation, a small chapel that is the final resting place of Dwight David Eisenhower and his wife Mamie, along with their firstborn son, Dowd, who died of smallpox at the age of 3. The last thing you would expect to see in the heartlands of Kansas are what we are about to explore, and they have been around for some 80 million years. Rising from the plains near Oakley are monument rocks that rise 70 feet into the blue sky, reminding me a bit of Stonehenge in England. Except these are not man-made. They were formed when the area was once covered by the Niobrara Seaway, that extended from the Gulf of Mexico north through Canada. When the sea evaporated, it left behind chalk deposits that over time eroded, creating monument rocks. This one is called Charlie the Dog. Their arches and buttes spread over 10 acres and are a spiritual site for Native Americans of the area. In 1962, it was named the first National Nature Landmark by the U.S. Department of the Interior. And here we are at the geographic center of the lower 48 contiguous United States. It's located in the small town of Lebanon, Kansas, and it's exactly 1,333.5 miles back to Burlington in Vermont. As early as 1918, this site was identified by a U.S. Geological Survey, and residents of Lebanon formed the Hub Club to develop this site for tourism, and their work continues to this day. Good job, Lebanon. And now we've moved on to the capital city of Nebraska. Do you remember what it is? Well, it's Lincoln, with this very impressive state house. Built in four phases, it was completed in 1932 at a cost of $9.8 million, a hefty sum in those days. Sitting atop the Golden Dome is the sower casting seeds, symbolic of agriculture in Nebraska that accounts for a quarter of the state's economy. The legislature has met as the nation's only unicameral governing body since 1937. The 49 senators lead a system of the people, and not the parties, that has worked well here. Before leaving, I have to show you the memorial chamber where public heroism is honored. This mural depicts Chief Standing Bear demanding his human rights in an Omaha courtroom. Rising up between the eight murals are Vermont antique marble walls trimmed with Belgian black marble. Nice to find a little piece of Vermont way out here. Next, we were off to the Ashfall Fossil beds. I've never seen anything like them before, and for me, it was a sad but fascinating story. In 1971, heavy spring rains eroded a deep gully at the edge of a farmer's cornfield. Later that year, the skull from a baby rhino was found in the washout. It lay near the bottom of gray ash, and turned out to be the first of more than 100 rhino skeletons excavated by University of Nebraska crews. If a time machine were to transport you back 12 million years, you would find Nebraska covered with patches of jungle, much like modern East African savannas. Inhabited by more than 50 now extinct species of animals and birds, and excavations have unearthed hundreds of these fossils. Their demise came without warning when a huge volcano erupted in what is now southwestern Idaho, spewing ash like a gray blizzard over the lush terrain. The confused and choking animals rushed to the nearest water holes, where they died one atop the other. This tragic story is well documented at Ashfall, and you can watch and chat with paleontologists who will continue to make discoveries for years to come. From here, it was on to Des Moines, the capital of Iowa, and my quest to visit all 50 states was achieved. I have been impressed with the state capitol buildings out here, and Iowa's is no exception with its five domes. The 23-karat gold dome, now under restoration, rises 275 feet above the capitol grounds. Entering the building is a grand experience. Completed in 1886, it is a showcase for art and many historical artifacts, and a splendid place to view the Rotunda Dome and its suspended flag, a reminder of Iowa's efforts to preserve the Union during the Civil War. This marble and granite stairway leads you to the second floor with the House Chamber to the right and the Senate to the left. Next, we headed for Ames and the Reiman Gardens on the campus of Iowa State University. This is the football stadium for the Cyclones that can accommodate 60,500 fans. Our tour started in the butterfly garden with more than 80 species of live butterflies, and here are just a few that I was able to get on video. This is the Atlas moth, the largest in the world, found in the tropical forests of Southeast Asia. Leaving the butterfly gardens, you're welcomed by Elwood, the world's tallest cement gnome, who stands 15 feet tall and weighs in at 3,500 pounds. Every year, Reiman Gardens has a different theme, and this year it celebrates water that sustains all life here on planet Earth. Washed ashore, the current theme is designed to bring attention to our ever-increasing problem of pollution of our oceans, lakes, and streams. To do this, artists have created 10 sculptures made of trash taken from beaches and riverbanks to illustrate, in a very creative way, the seriousness of what is happening.
So cute when they're small.
And I have saved the best for last, a visit to the Blue Bunny headquarters in Lamar's, known as the ice cream capital of the world. More ice cream is made here than any other location on Earth, and I couldn't wait to go inside to sample. Almost 100 years ago, Fred H. Wells and his sons began making ice cream. Wells is now the largest family-owned and managed ice cream producer, with 102 different flavors to suit every taste. It was hard to decide, but I chose the praline pecan, and I wish you could be here to enjoy a sample along with me. It was so good. And now here's a look at some of the cute things in the Blue Bunny souvenir shop. And of course, I brought home a Blue Bunny. I hope you've enjoyed being a part of my lifelong goal to visit all 50 states and there is a lot more that I didn't have time to show you. So when someone says there's not much to do out here in Nebraska, Kansas, and Iowa, you can tell them to the contrary. There are many fascinating and beautiful places that I didn't have time to show you, and there are very friendly people. For Across the Fence, I'm Lyn Jarvis, and thank you for watching.